Hello, my dear student. In today's science class, we will do a new chapter. Chapter number 10. The name of the chapter is Animals, Form and Function. Now, first of all, the learning objectives are the organ system inside our body, the body movements in different animals like earthworm, snail, cockroach, fish, bird and snake, the human skeletal system, the types of joints and their role in the movement of body, the role of muscles in movement. Now, the introduction. All living organisms are made up of tiny structure called cells. Depending on the number of cells, the organism either unicellular, it means it consists a single cell, or multicellular organism. Clear? Now, our first topic is the inside of our bodies, many organ systems are there. The organ systems are first digestive system, and the major organs are in digestive system, major organs are mouth, foot pipe, stomach, intestine, liver, pancreas. In respiratory system, major organs are nose, mouth, windpipe, lungs. Nervous system, brain, spinal cord, nerves. Circulatory system, heart, blood vessels. Excretory system, kidney, skin, bladder. Skeletal system, bones. Muscular system, muscles. Clear, children? These various organ systems are help our body to carry out the important function of our life. Now, our second topic is body movement. All animals show movement. The body movement of animals are related to their body structure. Animals move in a variety of ways like walking, running, flying, swimming, jumping, crawling, etc. Different body parts are used in these acts of movement from one place to another. Clear, children? Now, our third topic is movement in animals. First, we will discuss about earthworm movements. An earthworm has a long tube-like body. The body is made up of many ring or segments joined end to end. It has no bones. Muscle present in the body wall help the body to elongate it and shorten. Earthworm first extend its interior part or front part of the body, keeping the remaining posterior part fixed to the ground, and then fix the front part and release the posterior part. In this manner, earthworm moves forward. The body shape is maintained by a fluid present inside the body is known as liquid skeleton. Hope the movement of earthworm is clear to you all. Now, our next animal is snail. A snail is a very slow moving animal having a rounded structure called shell on its back. It is known as outer skeletal and is not made up of bone. Snails also have a pair of tentacles which bears eyes at the tips. Movement in snail take place by a muscular organ called foot, which produce a slimy fluid called mucus, so that the animal gets a smooth walk. The muscular foot produce a series of wave-like movements that help the animal to move forward. Okay, children? Third animal is cockroach. They do not have bones and their body is covered with a hard outer skeleton called exoskeleton. Cockroach walk, climb, as well as fly in the air. They have three pairs of legs which help in walking. They also have two pairs of wings attached to the breast muscles that help in flying. Fourth animal, fish. Fish live in water. They have streamlined body shape which offers least resistance to the flow of water and allow the fish to move in water easily. Fins, flexible bones and strong muscles help in swimming. Fins provide stability and direction while swimming and prevent the body from rolling. Muscles make the front part curved to one side and the tail part moves towards the opposite side. Then the front body part and the tail part quickly curve to the other side. This movement produces a jerk. A series of such jerks help the fish to swim forward. Clear, children? Now, our fifth animal is birds. Most birds can fly in the air and walk on the ground. They have streamlined bodies which make it easier for them to move in air. Bones are hollow and light, which makes their body light. They have wings with feathers. Flapping of wings provide both thrust and lift in the air. Strong breast muscle help in flapping of wings during flight. Hope the movement of birds is clear to you all. Our sixth animal is snake. Snakes move very fast by crawling on their bellies. Special structures called scales are present on their bodies. The scales help in crawling. They have a long backbone as the bodies are long. They have many tiny muscles connected to each other. During movement, the body curves into many loops. Each loop gives the snake a forward push by pressing against the ground. Snakes do not move in straight line. Hope the movement of snake is clear to you all. Now, our next topic is movement in human beings. Two systems take part in this movement. One is the skeletal system and the other one is the muscular system. The skeletal system consists of bones, which are hard in structure, and cartilage are soft and elastic. Other than the skeletal system also consists skull, backbone, ribs and limbs. First, skull. The skull is made up of 22 bones. All are fixed and joined except our lower jaw. It helps us to talk and chew food. Next, backbone. It is made up of 33 small bones. The rib cage is joined to this backbone. It protects the spinal cord. Next, ribs. Ribs are thin, flat, curved bones. form a protective cage is known as rib cage. It protects our heart and lungs. It consists of 24 bones arranged in 12 pairs. Next, limbs. Humans have two pairs of limbs. One pair of forelimbs, arms or hands, and one pair of hind limbs or legs. Okay, clear children? Now, our next topic is joints and movements. What is joints? The place where two or more bones are joined together are called joints. And what is ligament? The bones are held together at the joints by a strong structures are called ligaments. Now, the type of joints. There are main three type of joints. First, immovable joints. Second, slightly movable joints. And the third one, freely movable joints. First, immovable joints. These joints do not allow any movement. Joints between the bones of our skull is known as immovable joints of joints. Next, slightly movable joints. These joints allow very little movement. Joints between the ribs and the breastbone. Next, freely movable joints. These joints allow free movements of bones in various directions. Joints in the neck is the example of freely movement joints. There are four major type of freely movable joints in our body. First, ball and socket joints, which is present in our hip joint. Pivot joint, between the neck and the head. Hinge joint, elbow joint is known as hinge joint, and the gliding joint between the bones of the ankles are the example of gliding joints. Hope this joint and movement concept is clear to you all. Last part of this chapter is muscular system. Muscles are attached to the bones. This makes it possible for the bones to move at the joints. The muscular system consists of muscles. These muscles help in movement. Muscles have the property of contraction and relaxation. This is this property of the muscles which is responsible for the movement of bones. Hope this chapter is clear to you all.